homeowners, the prospective buyers and the new homeowners, the children. Well, now we're going to have thieves. And the one thing that I want to lift up to you that we've been doing Lenten series here at Zion for as long as I can remember, and many of you have been here year after year. Well, these two guys we've seen before. They robbed the potter's workshop in The Potter and Me, Freddie and Larry. So let's see if they've learned anything or have changed from that time. So you ready, Freddie? Are ready, Larry? All right. Enjoy.
Come on, let's check out the attic.
Why do we have to check out the attic? We got lots of stuff.
We got hardly nothing. Lots of folks think they're smart putting a safe or other valuables in the attic. They hide them. Let's go.
I'm coming. You know how I hate heights.
This doesn't count as a height.
The stairs, they're wobbly.
Give me a break and get up here.
I don't like it.
You are such a wimp. Look, if you're going to be a criminal, you have to start acting like one. No more scaredy cat, no more whining, and no more moments of moral realignment.
Huh?
No more thinking that stealing is such a bad and terrible thing. Remember, like about a year ago with the clay pot?
I remember you hitting me over the head and leaving me.
That's because you was acting like an idiot, thinking God was somehow sending us a message through a pot, telling us to change and repent.
Well, that pot said that. It said we were God's clay. It did.
It wasn't our pot. We were stealing it. So that message wasn't meant for us. Look, if God wanted to change us, what do you think God would do, huh?
I don't know.
He'd send a lightning bolt, or get us caught and arrested and sent to jail to share a cell with some big guy doing life for murder named Bruno. That would maybe make me repent, not a pot.
I still don't think you weren't listening right.
If God speaks up, I'll listen. Right, God? God? See? Nothing.
That ain't funny, Larry.
Let's see what they got and get out of here before someone gets home from work or something.
This is a lot of junk, Larry.
Well, look around.
Hey. How about this?
That doesn't do a thing for you.
Maybe we can sell it.
Maybe we could sell it. Will you look for something valuable? See if there's a safe or a coin collection or something like that.
Ah, look. Here's a whole box of photo albums. Oh, look. Here's a picture of the whole family at the beach.
Put that down.
Look at them. We never get to go to the beach. Oh, and here's a great picture of Christmas. I love Christmas.
I love Christmas too, Freddie, because there's more stuff to steal.
Here's a picture of the kids' Christmas pageant. Look, shepherds.
Will you put that down?
We never get to be in a Christmas pageant.
I was, one time.
What happened?
I stole the frankincense and gold.
Larry!
Hey, they said it was valuable.
But that's like stealing from Jesus.
It was a play.
You shouldn't steal in church, Larry.
Why do you think they don't let me usher no more?
You didn't.
I was just getting change and I forgot to put in my 50.
You can't lie to God, Larry.
Just get looking. What was that?
Huh?
Quiet. I think I heard something.
I didn't hear nothing.
I did. I heard a door. Somebody's home.
What are we going to do?
Quick, pull up the stairs.
The stairs?
The stairs. Pull them up and be quiet about it.
Oh, yeah. Now what?
Don't walk around. Just don't make any noises on the ceiling.
What are we going to do?
Shh. I hear music, a radio, or something.
I knew it. Now we're trapped.
Oh, just don't panic. Maybe they'll leave soon.
I don't want to go to jail and live with Bruno.
If you'll be quiet, we won't have to.
I told you we shouldn't come up here. You were greedy.
Well, of course I'm greedy. I'm a thief. That's why I steal.
We should have left them. We had most of it.
What if they had something really good up here? Then you wouldn't be saying that.
It ain't worth it, Larry.
And what else do you expect us to do? How are we going to eat?
We could get real jobs. I know we could.
You've gotten us fired from just about every job we've had. You remember McDonald's?
I couldn't help it. I like French fries.
And the Big Macs. They're supposed to have 2 all-beef patties. But no, they kept missing burgers because you thought you could eat one.
I was hungry.
I was hungry. You're always hungry.
I'm hungry now. Do you still hear them down there?
I don't know.
Ah!
Be quiet.
It's a monster.
What?
A monster. A wild animal. Back there.
It's probably a squirrel or something.
No, it's a giant rat or something. It's huge and has big fangs.
Where?
Back there.
Oh, let me see. I don't see anything.
It's back here. Here.
Oh, you idiot. It's just some stuffed animal head. There's a sign on it.
What does it say?
Elliot, Ghost of Earlwood Avenue. Curse upon ye who move me from my blessed rest.
Curse. See? See?
What now?
God is trying to get us. Don't you see?
I see that you're an idiot.
First God trapped us up here. And now this, a curse.
It's a joke. It's a piece of junk.
You always ignore God. This is God telling us we're cursed. Unless we let go of all this stuff, don't you see it? This is God speaking.
That's just some sort of stuffed elephant head, you idiot.
God will never let us out of this attic unless you give up crime. Unless we give up the stuff and promise to never steal again. If we don't, we're just going to stay here and rot.
I ought to stuff you. You're nuts.
Am not. Don't you get it? God's telling us we're not just stealing stuff, we're messing up families, like the ones in those pictures.
No, we're providing for our families.
Our cats don't count.
Well, they count to me.
I'm not stealing. And we're going to put this stuff back. All of it.
I am not.
You are too, or else.
Or else what?
Or else, I'm going to bang on the floor right here, and they'll call the cops, and you're as good as with Bruno.
You wouldn't.
You got to listen to God.
This wasn't God. It was a mistake. The lady came home early for lunch or something.
Oh, sure. And I guess it was just a mistake when that whale swallowed Jonah.
What are you talking about?
You know, Jonah and the whale.
It was a big fish, you idiot.
A whale is a big fish.
It's a mammal. Besides, what do you know about Jonah?
I was watching Jeopardy the other night.
Oh, now there's a strange picture.
I like Jeopardy.
And I like women, but I don't get the right answers with them either.
I learn a lot with Jeopardy, and they had some questions about Jonah. So I looked it up in the Bible. It's a small book. So I read the whole thing.
How long did that take you? A week?
No, 7 days. But it was good. And it was all about Jonah and a big fish, and how he tried to do different than God wanted, and how the fish swallowed him and then threw him up where God wanted him. Don't you get it? This is the belly of the fish. God caught us, and now God wants us to repent, just like Nineveh.
And if we don't?
And I don't know.
See, you don't know.
Maybe we're going to go, you know where.
Where?
You know.
Pittsburgh?
No. H-E double toothpicks.
Why should we go there more than anyone else? Do you think all those good old people in church on Sunday, do you think they repent so good? Do you think they change their ways? Oh, sure, Lent rolls around and they'll say, I'm going to change for a few days. At least I'm honest. Hey, God, this is what you get. I'm going to steal because it's all I know how to do. So if this is the belly of the big fish, well, you better throw me up somewhere else because I'm just going to steal there too.
We could try.
There's something to be said for honesty. I think God likes it.
Huh?
Sure. God appreciates my honesty. It's sort of like that thief on the cross beside him. I always liked him. He was going to be with God in paradise.
But he was giving up stealing.
Well, duh. What's he going to steal from a cross? Besides, how do you know?
He was going to be dead.
Well, maybe he would steal stuff in heaven. You know, a golden harp or two.
You can't steal in heaven.
And I don't want to go there.
Larry, you're going to get us killed by God someday. I mean, he's given us warnings, like that clay pot, us getting caught, and this stuffed animal.
God's not going to kill us, you moron. But you might get us caught. I'll tell you what. If you want to repent, fine. But you got a choice. You can repent in jail with Bruno, or you can help us get out of here with this stuff, which I will gladly keep if you don't want to steal. And then you're on your own. No more stealing.
You won't steal?
No. I said you were on your own. I'm going to keep stealing because I like it.
But Larry, that wouldn't be right.
Why not?
Because then if you go, you know, to Pittsburgh, and I get to go to paradise, well, we wouldn't be together. And we're buds.
I guess that's a chance you'll have to take. You can just abandon me. Leave me to perish, eternal fires, and all that kind of stuff.
You got to listen to me.
Not yet.
Then it's clear.
What?
I can't leave you. I'll have to keep stealing until you decide to repent too. I gotta be responsible for you.
You responsible for me?
Sure. I mean, it's sort of like the time we went hiking.
Okay.
Remember when we were younger and we went together and we got separated?
You mean when you went off in the bushes and got lost?
I had to tinkle.
Anyway, what about it?
Well, you looked for me and waited because you didn't want me to be lost out there. And I didn't want you to be lost. We're kind of on this journey. Yeah, we're on a journey together.
I'm not sure I like the idea of you being responsible for me.
Yep, responsible for Larry, for his soul. Sort of like Jonah was responsible for Nineveh, right?
You think God gave you that responsibility somehow?
Sure. Probably gave it to everyone on some sort of journey. Don't you think?
Shh. You hear that?
What?
I think the music's off.
You think she left?
I sure hope so. I can't stand another minute of your responsibility. Go check.
Huh?
Go check.
I'm not going down there without you.
Go on.
Nope. We're together, remember? Come on.
I'm starting to worry about you. Don't hold my hand, you moron. Wait a moment.
Larry, don't leave me.
I want that elephant head.
Oh, no, you don't. You can't take the elephant. I won't let you.
Why not?
Because like it says, we'll be cursed.
I'm already cursed with you.
I will hold my breath until you put it back. I'll turn blue, and maybe pass out, and maybe die.
All right. No elephant. Now, can we go?
I'm only taking this stuff for you.
Sure. Whatever. Let's go. I have to get me a new partner.